बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर महमूदा सुल्ताना शुभी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर आदिन सकिना वुमेन्स मेडिकल कॉलेज जशोर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिसकस अबाउट द हिस्टोलॉजिकल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम। एट फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज कार्डियोवास्कुलर सिस्टम? द सिस्टम दैट सर्कुलेट्स द ब्लड एंड लिम्फ थ्रू आउट द बॉडी। सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम कंसिस्ट्स ऑफ हार्ट, ब्लड वेसल्स, ब्लड, लिम्फ एंड लिम्फेटिक वेसल्स एंड ग्लैंड्स। सो पार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम आर हार्ट, ब्लड, क्लोज सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम दैट इज लार्ज और इलास्टिक आर्टरी, मीडियम और मस्कुलर आर्टरी, स्मॉल आर्टरी, आर्टरियोल्स, कैपिलरीज, वेन्यूल्स एंड स्मॉल वेन्स, देन लार्ज वेन। एट फर्स्ट द हार्ट, we know about this, the heart made by the cardiac muscle, and this cardiac muscle in the heart form the four chamber, that is two atrium and two ventricle, and this pumping organ will pump the blood through the circulatory system. The right and left ventricle propel blood to the pulmonary and systemic circulation, and right and left atria receive the blood from the blood and the pulmonary veins respectively. So different layer of the heart, there are three layers within the heart. The wall of the heart formed by the within outwards, the endocardium, myocardium and the epicardium. Then at first the endocardium consists of a thin layer of the endothelium, that is the simple squamous epithelium, and supported by connective tissue. And middle layer, the myoelastic layer of the smooth muscle fiber and connective tissue. Then under the endothelial layer, the endocardium layer, there is another layer, the subendocardial layer, a deep layer of the connective tissue merges with the myocardium. And branches of the heart impulse conducting system consisting of the modified cardiac muscle fiber are also located in the subendocardial layer. The thickest layer, myocardium, consists mainly of the cardiac muscle with its fiber arranged spirally around each heart chamber. And epicardium is a simple squamous mesothelium supported by a thin layer of the loose connective tissue containing the blood vessels and nerves. The epicardium corresponds to the visceral layer of the pericardium, the membrane surrounding the heart. So classification of the blood vessels, what are the blood vessels, and functionally we will classify in different category. The conducting vessel, first one, conducting vessel, the large artery, distributing vessel, that is a small artery, and resistance vessels, these are the arterioles are the resistance vessels, and exchange vessel, that means the sinus or capillary and capillary venules, post capillary venules, and capacitance or reservoir vessels, that is the large venules and veins. And regular structure of the blood vessels as a whole, in case of both vein and artery, the large vessels have wall with the three layers from inner to outer. The innermost tunica intima consists of the endothelium and a thin subendothelial layer of loose connective tissue, sometimes containing the smooth muscle fiber. In case of artery, the intima includes a thin layer, the internal elastic lamina, composed of elastin with holes allowing the better diffusion of the substance from blood deeper into the wall. And second layer, the tunica media, the middle layer consists chiefly with the smooth muscle cells. And in case of artery, the media may also have an external elastic lamina separating this layer from the outermost tunica. And outermost layer, the tunica adventitia or tunica externa, is a connective tissue consisting principally of the type 1 collagen and elastic fiber. Now the characteristics features of artery, first one, they are thick walled vessels and carry the oxygenated blood back away from the heart to tissue of the body, and they are more muscular than the vein, and their lumen is smaller than that of the accompanying vein and veins, and they don't have valves in their lumen, and would generally remain open even if flow stop because of the muscular structure. What are the types of artery? There are three types of artery. At first, the elastic artery, that means large artery, then muscular artery, medium size artery, and third one arteriole. So first of all, the structure of the elastic artery. These large vessels are also called the conducting artery because their major role is to carry blood to smaller arteries. The thick tunica media in which elastic lamina alternate with layers of smooth muscle fiber. The adult aorta has about 40 to 60 elastic lamina. The tunica intima is well developed with many smooth muscle cells in the subendothelial connective tissue. Between the intima and the media is the elastic internal elastic lamina, which is more well defined than the elastic lamina of the media, and the adventitia is much thinner than the media. And function of this artery: presence of numerous elastic fiber in the wall allow it to expand during contraction, and that means during systole, and to flow more evenly through the other arteriolar channel, making the blood flow more uniform. Example of these arteries: the aorta, the pulmonary artery, and their largest branches. And so in short, the histological structure of the artery, large artery or elastic artery, that are the wall consists of from inside to outward, tunica intima, tunica media, and tunica adventitia. And second one is series of 40 to 60 concentrically arranged elastic fiber present with few smooth muscle fiber in tunica media. And then tunica intima is thicker, but adventitia is relatively thin. External and internal elastic lamina is not prominent. Then muscular artery. Muscular artery, also called the distributing artery. The intima has an thin subendothelial layer and a prominent internal elastic lamina. The media may contain up to 40 layers of the large smooth muscle cells interspread with a variable number of elastic lamina. And external elastic lamina is present only in the larger muscular arteries. The adventitial connective tissue contains lymphatic capillaries, fossa vasorum, and nerve. And function of these muscular arteries is distribute blood to organ and help regulate blood pressure by controlling or relaxing the smooth muscle in the media. Example of this artery: renal artery, brachial artery, etc. And then arterioles. Arterioles, that means resistance vessels. Arterioles are generally less than 0.5 millimeter in diameter, and the subendothelial layer is very thin. Elastic lamina are absent, and the media consists of the circulating arranged smooth muscle cell, only one or two layers. So the terminal branches of arterioles are called the meta-arterioles, and these meta-arterioles have a smaller lumen and only few smooth muscle cells. These smooth muscles act as the precapillary sphincter, regulating the flow of blood through capillary network depending on the metabolic need of the tissue. They are the main source of the peripheral resistance to blood flow, that means resistance vessels, so called. So meta arterioles terminate into capillaries, and meta arterioles is connected directly with the venule by a thoroughfare channel. So thank you for today. Allah Hafiz.